Good morning. Today is Thursday. It is the 18th day of Cheshvan, Chai Cheshvan. Today we are continuing and completing the chapter 28, the 28th letter of Igeres HaKodesh. Now we started yesterday, and the letter, to review a little bit, this is a letter written to Reb Levi Yitzchak of Gaditchev, after he suffered a tragedy and his son passed away. His son's name was Meir, who was a big tzaddik. And the Alter Rebbe sent him a letter of consolation. And in this letter, the Alter Rebbe explains to him what is the meaning, what happens when a tzaddik passes away. And not just a regular tzaddik. Is it called the tzaddik elyon? There's a tzaddik, a higher level of a tzaddik. Because there are some tzaddikim that their job is to climb up and to go higher and higher. That's an ordinary tzaddik. And there is a tzaddik elyon. A tzaddik elyon is a supernal tzaddik. This is a tzaddik who reaches in the highest level and he brings down. He brings down the holiness. So here, the Alter Rebbe explains that when a tzaddik passes away, everything what he does, all of his acts and everything what he did through his lifetime, with mesiros nefesh, with giving his soul into it, that every day, twice by Shema, when you give mesiros nefesh, and the tzaddik is a constant connection to Hashem. And by him, everything during his lifetime, all of this, what he accomplishes is limited. But when he passes away, it reaches up in a place very high, which creates a union with its source. So when there is a union, there is birth of new lights. A new energy that comes down to this world. So he continues now explaining how it reaches to the place which is above the union, even above the Abba. Abba means father, it means also refers to Chachma, the wisdom. Why? Because the wisdom and understanding creates emotions. And that just like a father and a mother create a child. And it explains that this, what we said yesterday is that the chachma is biriru, with the wisdom, things become clear, clarify, which is the Abba, the level of father. And it continues to explain that where does the chachma receive from? The Chachma, the father, receives from a place which is much, much higher. And it says when Moshe Rabbeinu wanted to ask forgiveness for the Jewish people, and he said to Hashem that God should have mercy from the Jewish people. This was after the sin of the golden calf, when God wanted to destroy the Jewish people. And Moshe Rabbeinu asked mercy from Hashem, and he says to Hashem to have mercy in the merit of the fathers. In the merit of Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, Hashem should have mercy on the Jewish people. And Hashem told him, don't ask me for the merit of the fathers. The merit of the fathers, as great as they are, with all due respect, there is limited. And Hashem brought them to a higher place. And this is the place of the Yud Gimel Midas Arachamim, the 13 attributes of mercy. Reaching to the 13th attribute of mercy is a place which is unlimited, and that can bring forgiveness unlimited. And even not only to the sin, which are unintentional sins, but even to intentional sins. And that's what we said yesterday, that the Alter Rebbe asked the question, why the passing of Miriam, the righteous Miriam, the sister of Moshe and Aaron, the story of her passing was written next to the portion of the Parah Aduma, the red heifer, to teach us that just like the red heifer brings forgiveness, so too the passing of the righteous people brings forgiveness. And he asked, why red heifer? Every offering, every sin offering brings forgiveness. And he explained that this regular sin offering only brings forgiveness for things that we did unintentionally, but not for intentional sins. But the Parah Aduma brings a deeper forgiveness, and so too is the passing of a tzaddik. So let's see inside how the Alter Rebbe says this. Ve'ine, says the Alter Rebbe, Meidas Zois. Now it is known the Abba Yonek Mimazel Hashmini. The Abba, the father, which was first the Chachma, draws its sustenance from the eighth mazel. What are we talking about? What is the eighth mazel? The mazel refers to here what we said before, the 13 attributes of mercy. When you have the 13, they're called mazel, because mazel is something that drips like nozzle. And the shmini, the eighth attribute, what is the 13 attributes of mercy? It mentions in the Torah, Hashem, Hashem, Kel, Rachum, V'chanun, what we say by the prayers. So the eighth one is called Notzer Chesed. Notzer Chesed L'Alafim. So the Abbas, he says, the wisdom gets its nourishment, its sustenance, from this eighth mazel, which is Notzer. Hu tikkun Notzer Chesed. This is the tikkun of Notzer Chesed. Now it says, Notzer Chesed la'alafim, that Hashem guards the Chesed, the kindness for thousands. What is the connection with Notzer? Says the Alter Rebbe, Notzer oisiyos ratzon. Notzer has the same letter as Ratzon. What is Ratzon? The will. What that means, to give a little more explanation, there is a difference between, what is the difference between the wisdom and the will? The will is something which is much more powerful. The wisdom is something that the person achieves. He can get wisdom. He can acquire wisdom. It's not something that is one with the person himself. The will is an expression, an extension of the very essence of the soul of the person. It's not something that a person acquires. It's not that there's a certain will staying there, and if you want, you can get that will. No. Wisdom is something, and intellect is something which is outside of the person. And if you have the tools, you can acquire this wisdom. But the will is an expression of the person himself. And that's why the will can create wisdom. Says sometimes even people that are not very smart, but if it really affects them deeply, they can come up with some brilliant ideas, because it affects them, affects the will. When they have a strong will in a certain things, he can bring out the wisdom. So he says, that's what he says, that the wisdom, notzar otiyot ratzon, and the Abba receives from this level of wisdom. So what happens? He says, "Vehu vehi eis rotzein." This is the eight rotzein. The time, they say certain special auspicious times, they call it et ratzon, a time of will. What does it mean, a time of will? That there is, from Hashem, there is the will of Hashem, so to speak, is being revealed, which is higher than the chokhmah, higher than the wisdom. Amizgalo meir b'pchinas gilui, this is revealed and shines in a revealed manner. It's interesting, mentions the word meir. Meir means shining, but this was also the name of the Reb Levi Yitzchak's son that passed away. So it mentions Amizgalo meir b'pchinas gilui, milemailo lemato. This will is being revealed when the tzaddik, when the supernal tzaddik, when the tzaddikim pass away, that will is being revealed. Those tzaddikim who serve God with love, surrendering their soul during their lifetime, every time, every evening, and every morning, Aviz v'shachiz b'kriya Shema, when they're reading the Shema. Shal yedei ze hayomalin mayin nukvim le'aba v'ima. Because thereby they would elevate mayin nukvim. Mayin nukvim means feminine water, meaning that they bring up to Hashem the desire from below, which is considered feminine waters, to Abba and Ima, to the level of Chachma and Bina, Abba and Ima, father and mother. B'kriya Shema Kayadua, during the reading of the Shema, as it is known. V'chein b'talmud Torah de'b'chachma nafkas. The same applies to the study of the Torah, which is derived from Chachma. So there too, they elevate, bring up my nukvim, the feminine waters, meaning their desire to connect. Now this, the mayim duchrim, duchrim means the masculine waters. They are elicited and they are drawn down from the level of Neitzer Chesed. V'heim heim ameihirim u'bebchinas gilui b'ptirosam. Now during the lifetime, this is not so much revealed. But after the passing, when a person completes his work in this world, this brings and shines in a revealed way when they pass away. That's what happened when a tzaddik passes away. Kanoida, as it is known, shekol amala adam she'om lo nafshoy bechayev. It is known that every effort of man, which a man has toiled during his lifetime, lemailo bepchinas helem ve'esta. During his lifetime, that whatever you do remains in the higher places, in the higher worlds. And then it remains above in a hidden way, in an obscured way. And when the person passes away, it is revealed and radiates in a manifest way, from above downwards, in the time of his passing. Now, says the Alter Rebbe, by the illumination from the level of Neitzer Chesed, which we said is the Rotz and the will, that is revealed at the time of the passing of the Tzaddikim, Meir Chesed Hashem Me'oilom Ve'ad Oilom Al Yereyev. The Chesed of Hashem, the chesed of God, radiates from world to world, from the higher world, from the concealed world, down all the way to this revealed world. Al Yareyov, to those who fear him, the people who are connected to the Tzaddik, the people who fear Hashem. Upo Yel Yeshua is bekerev ha'oretz, and this light that shines brings down and affects salvation in the midst of the earth. Lechaper al avoy nadoil, to atone for the sin of the generations, of his generation. Not only the unintentional sins, but av gam al azdoinois, sheim gimel klipeis atmeya shelemata menoiga. Even on the deliberate sins, which they are from the three impure klipis, impure shells, which is below the level of noiga. Noiga is the klipa, the shell that is potentially can become good, like all of our animalistic instinct comes from klipas noiga. We can do it in a positive way. As the Alter Rebbe says in the beginning of Tanya, that when even the nefesh ha-bahamis, the animal soul of a Jew, is also not ultimate impurity. It only as a result of that, a person can lead the person, God forbid, to fall lower. So the unintentional sins, they come from klipas noiga, from the shell which is a neutral shell. But this intentional, the deliberate sins, they come from a lower place. And the passing of a tzaddik brings forgiveness even on the intentional sins. Lefishe mazel de noitza, because the mazel, the level of the attributes of noitza, noitza chesed, is mimoichim stimim de arich ampim. They come from the moichim stimim of arich ampim. This refers to the level of keser, the crown, which is above the chachma. Mokir abirurim. This is the source of the refinements, birurim, the source where it can refine the material world. Veisapcho chashoichel et neshviras akelim. And it can do the transformation of the darkness from the breakings of the vessels to light of the oilamatikim, the world of correction. This is what we explained before. Breaking of the vessels brought godliness into the lowest places. And here it fell into the darkness. And when you have such a powerful light that comes from the Noitzer Chesed, it enables to transform even the darkness. That is through the passing of the Tzaddikim, which he compares to the Parah, the burning and the waters of the Parah of the red heifer. Masha'enkin bekorbonis she'ala mizbeach. This is not the case, though, with the sacrifices that is offered upon the altar, she'eina mechaprim elo alashgogeis. They only forgive on the unintentional, the inadvertent sins. She'eim izgabus nefesh abahamis sheminoiga. The unintentional, inadvertent sins, they come about because of the strengthening of the animal soul, whose life force derives from noiga, from the neutral klipa. As is stated in the book Likutei Torah, in the portion of Vayikra, this then is why the passage concerning Miriam is adjacent expressly to the passage of concerning the red heifer, not the regular carbon, the red heifer, ma porochulo. Why? Because the red heifer also has this great, as we said before, the Alter Rebbe explained yesterday, the kiddush mechatos, the sanctifying of the waters of the chatos, And it says, "Ubelialkut parsha shemini neyalkut shemini." In the portion of shemini, higia mechatas v'chulu. There, it says, it reads the water of the purification. Now, the water, it says, why? Just like the water of purification forgives, so too, the passing of a tzaddik forgives. So there has a little different version. Instead of saying what, just like the red heifer, it says just like the water of the purification. And in that version, it fits more with the explanation that the Alter Rebbe just explained. Because just like water, it comes down from the highest level and brings it down. So too, the passing of a tzaddik brings about atonement. It brings about such a great revelation that comes down and it brings atonement even on the intentional sins. So this is the end of chapter 28. Gives us a bit better understanding and appreciation of the special work of tzaddikim and how we, by connecting to the tzaddikim, following the instructions of the tzaddikim, we're able to get this blessing, atonements, and so on and so forth. And ultimately, this will lead to the bringing and the revelation of Mashiach Tzidkenu. Thank you for joining. Zat Hashem will continue tomorrow morning. Please share. Please invite your friends to join us and share the YouTube videos and so on. All the best. Any questions we can ask now.